What is up, guys? MiniBean75 here, and today I'm back with another episode of Minecraft Creations. This, guys, is going to be the WWE Elimination Chamber 2010 arena. This arena looks awesome. I'm really curious to know what you guys think about it. Here's what the stage looks like. I think it looks really cool. It's really unorthodox compared to what we've definitely seen in the past. 2010 had some pretty cool options. I think right after 2010 is where it kind of started to go a little bit less original, we'll call it. But yeah, anyway, guys, let's take a look at the stage itself. The stage looks absolutely awesome, like I said. Really unorthodox, because I'm really weird about, like, I want it to be even, like, height-wise and everything like that, and this is definitely not even. But this is how they had it set up. Basically, on the left side, as you guys can see, was a screen right here, and then basically it had, basically a little structure of scaffolding set up that was basically supposed to look like the Elimination Chamber. Very similar to the Elimination Chamber 2012, actually, that I ended up doing a little bit later. So obviously that one came after this, but this obviously is what kind of started that little structure that they had set up. And then over here, basically, we've got our main Titantron screen like this. Very unorthodox for 2010, considering that this isn't really widescreen. And then basically right here, we've got our typical... basically our typical screens right here that would show the superstar banner and stuff like that. And then this is right around this time is where they started doing, you know, the different just tall, big tall screens or cylindrical screens, stuff like that, where they would show the superstar banner. So, like I said, around, I think 2009, 2012 is when they really started, or 2009 or 2010 is when they really started doing that. So that's what this screen right here is for. So yeah, here's what the stage looks like, guys. I think it looks awesome. Definitely let me know down below what you guys think. And then our overhead ring lighting is exactly what we've already seen before. This is pretty much standard now for my Minecraft builds, you know, for the newer WWE arenas. But that's because this is pretty much standard for what the WWE goes with now. And then down here, we've got our Elimination Chamber. This is obviously still the older version of the Elimination Chamber, which I'll be honest with you, I actually think I like this better. I think it feels a little bit more raw than the new version. And it just looks a little bit cooler. Plus, in Minecraft, I think mine looks really cool. So, anyway, we can pop back in here. We can take a look inside the Elimination Chamber for anybody who hasn't seen my Elimination Chamber. If you haven't, go on to my How to Build playlist on my YouTube channel, and you can take a look at how to build your own Elimination Chamber in Minecraft just like this. So, anyway, guys, if I can get out of the cage here. Here we go. Okay, now let's go over here, and we are going to turn on the intro pyro for the show. Flip that switch there. And as you guys can see, it is just going to be a huge cluster of fireworks. That's literally exactly how they actually had it set up, with a bunch of different colored fireworks. I think it looks really cool, especially if you kind of sit back in the distance like that. Man, that definitely looks like the real thing, I would say. It's just fireworks just a-going. Obviously, they got music playing, and typically when they do this, they got the camera, you know, panning different ways so you can see different parts of the crowd and whatnot. So, yeah, I think it looks awesome. I'm definitely curious to know what you guys think about it. Make sure you comment down below and let me know. Let me know what other arenas you want to see me make next, or if there's anything else you want to see me make in Minecraft aside from a wrestling arena, because I can build literally anything, guys. So let me know that down below. And as always, guys, make sure you hit that like button down below. You have no idea how much that helps me out. If you want to see some exclusive time lapses and other exclusive content, guys, make sure you head down in the description to my Patreon account. For literally as low as $1 a month, you guys get to see some awesome exclusive content that only the folks that help support me are going to get to see. Then you can take a look at my online store. That link is also going to be found in the description. Get yourself some awesome MiniBean 75 merchandise for a great price. Other than that, guys, I just want to thank you guys for watching. Have a good one.